it's me. I had my screen on for a while, like 4 minutes, because I peed again, because I actually ate breakfast before stream, believe it or not. Wow. I don't do that typically, I've realized. It's usually during stream or like 5 hours after stream, because right after streams I tend to pass out because I have a very, 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 very normal sleep schedule. Or so I found. Just kidding. I pulled an all-nighter the night before last night, which was really funny. Speaking of last night and whatever the heck happened yesterday, I'm so very sorry for everything that happened yesterday. It was a mess and a half. So first, I pulled an all-nighter, right? I pulled an all-nighter, and I was like, oh no, this collab is gonna be so scuffed. It's gonna be so freaky. Not freaky. That's not the right word. Can't think of the word. It's gonna be so kerfuffled. That's the word. I guess that's the word we're gonna use. I was like, oh no, it's just not gonna turn out great. And maybe it'll be funny, but it's not gonna be the best because tired, sleep deprivation. Yay! Insomnia. So yeah. So then that happened. And so then, me and Tensu had originally planned to get on Discord at like 7:30 to do like sound checks, to do like stream checks, to see if everything was going okay, right? That was the original plan. And so then, what's it called? 7:30 hits. And I'm awake. And then, Tensu isn't, but I'm like, okay, well, you know what? We're both sound people. We'll know what's going on. It's fine. It's fine. It'll work out. Cromer jump scare. Yeah. Even if the technology is being all funky, at least we have Cromer. That's all that matters. Yeah, Cromer. Yay. Where was I? Oh yeah. Okay. So then that happened and I figured, okay, well, you know, he's probably just asleep. We can wait a little bit longer. Yeah, and so wait a little bit longer, and then he wakes up, sends me a message, and is like, yo man, sorry, my thing was updating. And I was like, okay, that's cool. But then guess what? The internet in the entire house goes out, and then it stays out for the next like 4 or 5 hours. Yeah, and but this time it wasn't a matter of like someone intentionally turning it off so that I could, you know, come out of my room and stop dying of vitamin D deprivation or whatever. No, it just straight up was like sound effects. Yeah. So then that happened and we were all like, bro. And also I didn't have like any data working because low key we're kind of in the mountains, but not really. So it's kind of like barren. So that happened, and that's why the collab didn't happen yesterday. Because by the time it like got back up, I was already like doing things, and it was just, it was a time. It was very much a time. Yeah. So I think what I should do is convert this one module, and then actually like, you know, to do the mirror dungeons that I was planning to do. I didn't even do my weekly pass yet. I actually missed yesterday's Dante notes. I think. I did, yeah, I did. Because it said it expired, and I was like, no, Dante notes. That's not Dante notes, where am I? So I should probably look at Dante notes. Yeah, it really was a time. It really was a time. Yeah, so it's rescheduled to next week, Tuesday, which I originally had off, but you know what, if it's in the morning, I think I can manage. And since I missed a whole stream yesterday, since I missed a whole stream yesterday, I'm gonna see if I can try and make it up in the morning tomorrow. I definitely can't Friday because I'm gonna be like dead Friday morning. But maybe if I'm not dead Friday morning, I'll make it up again because, yeah. Nante's notes expire. Yeah, they do. The rewards expire. Where's the things? I don't know where the things are, but trust me, they expire. And I was so like, I was like screaming inside because I was like, oh no, I didn't get my 100 lunacy. No. There's three. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. But I could. There's three. You know, you never know. But I'm not doing that. We're not pulling. We're gonna look at the Dante notes I missed. Like, you'll get the notes. It's just you won't get the rewards, which sucks balls, but oh well, if you like that. What's the newest one? Is it this one? Okay, I guess it's this one. Sinners seem to experience a kind of dizziness when they get near this thing. I hear it's called resonating, and it might be similar to how I got headaches. Once we return with the bell, Virgilius calls people from some other department to take care of it. When I asked him about this, he just said it's submitted to headquarters. That's really not suspicious at all. I really do need to finish Leviathan. Oops. I got to chapter 12, and then chapter 12 suddenly like threw words instead of pictures at me, and I was like, oh no, I'm not literate enough to do that. So, yeah. Speaking of literacy, I got to chapter 2 of Moby Dick. It only took me like 4 days because I have the attention span of a fly. Yeah. It looks like there's a pretty wide variety of offices. Thinking back on the time we were in the back streets of District 4, D-Corps territory, the office Yuri and Aya belonged to might have been the most common type. Anyways, I guess I can say fixers, offices, and associations are all entities that handle requests for a price. As most places do, methinks. Okay. I don't know how to say this. This association. They seem to specialize in single combat and dueling requests. Do we have any IDs from this place yet? I don't think we do. That's real funny. They seem to specialize in single combat dueling requests. Though it doesn't happen often, I hear there are still cases of people trying to settle disputes with a fair and honorable duel. This sounds very Don Quixote-like. When a person gets involved in a duel or has to challenge someone to it and figures their opponent will clearly tear them a new airway, they send this association a request. Sounds like they stand in for the client or something. All I know about this association comes from what I heard from the 7 association identities, so I can't learn much. Oh, the 7! Okay, that makes more sense. So I guess this really does sound like, this sounds so Don Quixote, the whole duel thing and honorable and fair and whatever. You said this association, I thought you meant disassociation. I was so ready to accept it. Oh yeah, the disassociation. My favorite association. I'm a part of that association, actually. Actually, I'm one of their main staff, you know? Me when the mental illness is mental illnessing. It's been doing that the past few days. It really is. It really do be a time. And that's why I couldn't sleep for like 2 days straight. Yeah, we're co-workers, let's go. Us and the disassociation. Dis nuts. I'm so sorry. I don't know where that came from. 9 to 5 at the disassociation. Some of us be working overtime at the disassociation. The dis nuts. Yeah, the disassociation specializes in nut production. No, wait, that sounds so bad. Wait, no. Not production. That's no. No. I don't know. I don't know how to make that sound better. No. The disassociation and I cannot make that sound any better. I'm so sorry. I do not know where that came from. Oh no. Oh no, this is what happens when I take off the hat. The hat has like 2 brain cells in it, and those are the 2 that keep me a little bit more functional. Those are the 2 that keep me from not working 24/7 at the disassociation. It is a necessary limiter. What if I turned it back on? Do I turn the hat back on? No, I'm lazy. Oh man. Anyways. Since the association doesn't get requests too often, it seems to be in charge of holding joint conferences and events with other associations as well. Great! Sanity hat, just like in that one in Don't Starve Together. Wow. I still don't know the hats in Don't Starve Together. I just know that there's like one that looks real funny like, and they all look real funny like, and it makes you like super warm, but also it keeps you sane. So it's great for the winter or something. I don't know anything about Don't Starve Together. I'm really bad at the game. All I do when I play the game is I immediately run to the farming mechanics and the sailing mechanics while my friends all deal with all the scary hard stuff like killing things and fighting frogs and exploring the swamp. While they do that, I'm like, wow, my tomatoes are looking real tomato-y today. Woohoo. I should play Don't Starve Together. That's a fun game. New association. My favorite association. Woohoo! And by favorite, I mean they made me cry. I hate League Association. They made me cry. I hate them in a loving way, you know? Anyways, according to Don Quixote, discerning the two may yet be a task too daunting for novice aficionados, she also added. While the association covers one-on-one situations like duels, the association handles engagements between multiple combatants. Come to think of it, most of those identities did seem to value cooperation and coordination over individual action. They also looked rather carefree, too. Gregor's Liu Association identity also told me that it was common for him to take on groups of five or six at once. He didn't forget to proudly mention that he'd whipped those kids' heinies. That's such an old man thing to say. Oh my god, that's such a 35-year-old tired man thing to say. He whooped those kids' heinies? Who says that? Oh... The more we learn about Gregor, the more endearing he becomes. It is such a Gregor moment. Oh my goodness. He's such a bro. He really said, whoop those kids' ideas. Who said that? Who says that? Oh, I love him. Another thing of note is the incendiary devices built into all their weapons. When I asked why they use fire-starting weaponry, they gave me varying answers like harmony or flow. Those honestly felt like roundabout remarks. In my opinion, it's probably because fire is effective as a means to strike foes around the target. Flames can spread after all. That's really thinky of you, Dante. That is really thinky of you, Dante, actually. Especially considering romance hair is literally fire. Oh, that's a lot of stuff. Okay. I'm gonna assume this all came from, like, yesterday, because I skipped yesterday. Abnormalities. I still don't think I can exactly define what an abnormality is. So far, the ones I've encountered, for now anyway, usually had an appearance unlike any human or animal and possessed extraordinary powers. They're beings you'd only expect to see in abnormal fantasies, both in terms of what they look like and what they can do. Maybe they look like they came from abnormal fantasies because they're called abnormalities. Just a thought. Ahem. I feel like I've read that before. Ahem, EGOs. Things I can't get because my gacha look hates me. Shorthand for extermination of geometrical organ. I don't know what the Broman really wrote IDK what this means. Not even I don't know what this means. Just straight up IDK what these means. I know, right? Like, it gave me the idea, like, the whole identities are real and like they merge a little bit with the personalities of the original sinner. Gave me the idea of like normal Sinclair just kind of like slowly becoming, and by slowly I mean very not really slowly, becoming more and more messed up because of the Encore identity. And like I don't know, I feel like that would be a fun fanfic idea to explore. Alas, my fanfic days are over. we ended at Con Allen. No, we didn't. What was the last thing I wrote? I genuinely can't remember. I think it might have been, like, Nayushiki or something. It was really late last year. I think, like, July or something. God, I want to write it so bad, but... My words just don't want a word. Help, like, reading books helps, but... I just can't words, you know? Yeah... But it's, like, I don't know. Because also, freaking Encore Sinclair, that's so... He's so OP. Like, it's natural that you would end up using him a lot. And so he would start merging with normal Sinclair a lot. So it's like, that's a fun thing to explore. Speaking of Encore IDs, Encliff is so different from regular Heathcliff. I wonder how people react. True! Like, dude, imagine he's, like, killing everyone again, and then suddenly he gets, like, all timid, and then suddenly he's, like, breaks down on the floor crying, like, because of Encliff. Like, bro, these, like, finding out that the IDs start to, like, merge a little bit with their own personalities, that really messes me up. And I'm not even, like, that messes me up more than it messes up the actual sinners. And they're messed up already. Man. EGO are byproducts of the Incafala generation, once done by the now-collapsed Alcor. Reports say the Wing originally produced weapons and equipment out of the EGO for its employees to use, which doesn't really seem to be match what I've seen of it. Whoa. I still don't get EGOs, Dante. I like this part. Reading the warning on the side, ingesting it apparently has hallucinogenic effects. Who would think to do that? And then we look over to the left. Netzach is there, just completely, like, high out of his mind, high as a kite. Oh, I love Netzach. He's seriously the guy ever. Incafalon seems to be what the glowing green fuel originally produced by Lobotomy Corps is called. Mephistopheles has a device converting humans into Incafalon built into it, and the green liquid filling up the tube seems to be just that. Incafalon can also be stored in containers of our choice for easier transport, boxes and modules being the two vital examples. Ho 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 ho. So basically, we're just constantly carrying around drugs with us. Nice to know! Also that I'm, like, bringing Enclair to the Cromer fight, and her reaction has so many more implications now that it's a canon possibility rather than just an Easter egg. Dude, right? Like, imagine being Cromer, and imagine, like, you don't know that you're about to, you're gonna be your last battle. Like, personally, if I were Cromer, and it was just me and, like, Sinclair, because remember, like, at the end of the Kanto 3, everybody was melting or melted. It was pretty much just, like, Sinclair, but his arm was already melting off. You could see his bones. And Dante, like, in the back, also melting. Like, Sinclair, like, imagine seeing that as Enclair instead. Like, bro. And then right after that, Damien comes along. Like, imagine how freaked out Cromer must have been, like, in her last moments, assuming you, like, use Enclair during that and, like, the Damien thing. Like, bro, like, it almost makes me feel bad for her. Dante melting, like the famous clock painting. So true. Everything is a reference if you think hard enough. Oh, I'm so everybody who watches me is so lucky that I haven't finished Damien by Hermann Hesse, that I'm only halfway through the book, because if I figure out, like, the specifics of what's going on in the next 70 pages, those are probably going to be the only things I talk about. I just know a general gist of how the story goes. I just know Frau Eva and, I don't know, they kiss at the end. But it's not a real kiss because it was just Sinclair, like, hallucinating in the military hospital or whatever. I don't know. Man, this book. It really is a book, man. I can't believe I got the last copy in the bookstore. I was, like, freaking out. I was like, oh, ho, ho, it's got the egg. Yeah. Oh, I hate this book so much. It makes me so insane. Oh. Hem, 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 hem. All Dalcor's logos and hills will be done, blah, 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 blah. Wing, use them as well, blah, blah, blah. Hallucinogenic effects, woohoo. Singularities. Simply put, some kind of incredible technology owned by the Wings. I was curious how they're different from the other technologies in the city. I guess it's the fact that singularities are monopolized by the Wings that own them. Fun times. Thread. Okay. They have an explanation for thread? That's crazy. A strangely shaped object is inside, kind of like a bulb-like thing. I don't know how I should describe it. It sometimes wiggles and twitches. What? It does? Staring into this glimmering thread makes me feel rather woozy. Faust wouldn't let me hold it in my hands for long, so I put it back in place and let her explain what it is. In summary, it's all sorts of possibilities woven into spindles of thread, or something like that. To be frank, I can't really call this a summary when I just wrote down what Faust said almost word for word. I couldn't understand what she meant exactly. It gives me a similar feeling to looking up at the star that appears when I wind the clock. Sort of like awe. Huh. You're telling me these silly things? Huh. Fun times. Hokey dokey. Now we get to the main part of this stream where I do mirror dungeons 7 times and I start screaming and crying and dying because I need to do them 7 more times to get to finish this one seasonal, because literally every other seasonal is finished except for this one, because mirror dungeons make me scream. I read this one Steam review once, was like, mirror dungeons are so tedious, I started applying for jobs. I did that too. One time I was straight up sitting there for like 30 minutes with a mirror dungeon opening as I scrolled through Indeed looking for jobs that weren't fast food. Mirror dungeons. So, my bets are that by 8:30 I'm gonna start like banging my head on the wall. Yep. I love when meta-functional items actually exist. IDs technically count as this. So true. It's like, because, you know, in-game currency and stuff, it's not really something you really think about, or, like, a lot of these things down here, you know? Not really something you think about in gacha games. But then here comes Limbus Company, like, guess what? Everything has a purpose. The Odyssey had a purpose. Okay. Okay. Dungeons. Mirror. Oh, I can't believe the season ends next week. Like, exactly a week from now. That's crazy. That's just smack up like random things together. We should try to make this fun. You know what? What if we try to do this with like only identities? Not identities, like specific identity groups. Let's, what, can we Liu association this to death? To death. I wonder if that's a thing I can do. Also, while I'm on Gregor's page, someone pointed out that everything, like, he pretty much always has his eye, an eye cover, not hit, like, not here, but in his IDs, they're pretty much covered, like, so, in many of them, like, this one, this guy's gonna play Limbus with only identities, no way, me and the wording, oh god. What I meant was, like, only identities from specific sections, you know? Oh, game. I don't want to look at identity. Okay. I probably shouldn't point it out here, but someone pointed out many times Gregor has an eye covered. We're using Liu section. Let's try this with Liu section, because I know I have everyone here. And if they all die, then it's okay. We can do mirror dungeons 8 times. crying, shaking, sobbing, even. Oh, and so it begins. Our long, treacherous journey of 7 whole mirror dungeons in a row. Because I'm very, very good at spacing. I feel like if I could think a little bit more during mirror dungeons, this would be a lot nicer. Alas, I don't think during mirror dungeons, because everyone is uptight, so I can just slap the win rate button and sign up for jobs on Indeed or something. I wish jobs would respond to me, but they're not. Oh my god. You know, I actually signed up for an audio engineer position at a certain place, I won't name names, and then they never got back to me. But also, I don't know if they're... But, like, which is fair. If it was just a skill thing, that'd be fair. But I don't know if they even saw it in general, because they're also holding auditions for talents, and I'm like, oh, man. So now part of me is like, what if I auditioned as a talent, but then instead of, like, showcasing anything relating to streaming or content creation, I'm just like, hey, remember your audio engineer position openings? Man. Look at them fighting. I should start my own office in real life. I'll offer to my fixers in my office. We're gonna make, I don't know. What do fixers do other than kill people? They fix things, supposedly, but fixing can be many a thing. I can fix them a mean sandwich. Just kidding. I can't make sandwiches. We don't have bread in the house. we need to go grocery shopping. Why did I say it? Grocery shopping? Who says it like that? Oh my god. I love when my words don't want a word. Wee! Go, Mersault! Yay! You're slaying! Literally! Yeah! All fixers are great at making sandwiches. It's part of the process. You're so right, sinner sandwich off. We'd make the best sandwich out of the sinners. I feel like... Let's see. We know that Yusang would obviously not make a good sandwich. He'd hand you, like, a green piece of bread and be like, this is my sandwich. I hope it tastes good. Oh, Mersault, absolutely. Bro is the cook ever. I wonder if there's a tier list we could do. Who makes the best sandwich? Who would make the best sandwiches? Like, one of those sorters. Does that exist yet? I know there's, like, a sorter for everything. Hold on. Limbus Company sorter. Hole. I'm gonna pull it up. We should make a tier maker stream. You know, sometimes I think about recording a video that's like a tier list video that's like ranking Limbus Company characters based on how bisexual they are. I don't know why that was like the first thing I thought of when I got into playing the game. I think I saw Sinclair and I was like, that man is 100% like bi. I don't know why, he just is. I think this is just me projecting again. I love projecting on characters I love. Ranking Limbus Company characters based on how good a sandwich they'd make. Oh my god, you know what? Since I found the sorter, Let's message this to myself, and let's press the win rate button. Let's message this to myself, right now. I will straight up pull up a thing. Actually, you know what? We don't need a whole sorter. Let's just do the sinners for now. We don't need a whole sorter. Let's. Where's the text box? Text box. Haha. Press the win rate button. Where's OBS? Okay. Best sandwich making sinner. One. Oh, whoa. How many are there? There's like, not including Dante, there's 12. Best sand. Oh, you're right. I need to adjust the thing, but I'll put numbers. Yeah, six. Number six is seven, definitely. 10, 11, 12. You know what? Let's do 13. Dante can be there too. Why not? I believe in him. Him, them. Woo. Counting. Yes. I'm so good at counting. I can count to 8. That's a real musician moment. I'm not even a musician, man. Not anymore. Ugh. The best sandwich making sinner. Let's make this a little bit. There we are. Who cares about mirror dungeons? We have sandwiches to make. Let's pick this one. I don't even know what it does. Sinclair, we'll pick you and then we'll proceed to make you not do anything. This is Liu section only. Phew. I wonder if Dante remembers anything about cooking. Just right off the bat. Would Dante be good at cooking? Would Dante be good at sandwich making specifically? What if Dante worked at Subway in their past life? There's the thing. Here it is. Him. So first, Mersault. Amazing. We absolutely have to put either Yusang or Greg last. Considering Greg actually cooks for other people, I'm willing to put him 12 instead of dead last. So we can put these two, Yusang, Yusang. Let's see. I think Dante would be around rank 4 to 6, but because everyone else is worse than them. You're so right. Who would make a worse sandwich? Let's see. Who would most definitely make a worse sandwich than Dante? Ryoshu. I do not trust Ryoshu, respectfully. You take a bite of that thing, it's gonna taste like 20 different cigarette packs. Ryoshu makes sandwich with evil intent. You're so right. I feel like, who else? I think Roja. I don't know why. I get the impression that she would try to make one of those like cream sandwiches with the fruits in them, but then she'd put like a crap ton of sugar in there or something, and it just, or maybe even just a crap ton of cream, and then it would become soggy and weird instead of like sandwichy and edible. Put love in your cooking. Ryoshu puts hate in her cooking. You're so right. Oh, wait. Is this a new one? Whoopsie. Hear the quiet flickering of candles. Wooden dolls standing. Filling the room for a wish. Does this wooden doll wish for anything? Remove the wall talismans. Oh, okay. Sinclair, this is what you're here for. Go, our sacrifice. Yeah. Do you mean continue? Continue. Combat encounter, bro. Roger would try her best, and I would eat it because I love her. You're so right. Okay, wait. I should edit this. I'm gonna put Ryoshu like here. Oh, thank you for following. I hope you enjoy our sandwich talk, our sinner sandwich talk. Did Sinclair lose his something in peace? He might have. let's see. Where would Sinclair rank? Does Sinclair even eat sandwiches? Would Sinclair eat sandwiches? Do rich boys eat sandwiches? Saying this as if that's literally not my character. Oops. No, we don't eat sandwiches. but also, Sinclair has like a decent tongue, so I feel like he wouldn't make something awful. It'd be like a little strange tasting, maybe. Not like strange tasting, just a little bit off. Like an American convenience store sandwich. It'd be like, there's something about this that doesn't taste quite right, but it's, you know, it's edible. I don't think I'll die from it, per se. Ishmael, second place. You're so right. I feel like maybe the boat got to her. Ishmael. Ishmael? Ishmael. Hell yeah, okay. No, don't cancel. Ishmael. Oh my god, I did it again. Ishmael. There we are. Okay. So, Ishmael. Ishmael second. Yeah, I feel like Ishmael would be pretty good. Can we put Heathcliff like 10th? Just because he's British? But also, like, tea parties and whatever. I don't know. Maybe he would be... He'd be good at, like, those tiny cucumber ones. Probably. Like, they're edible-ish to an extent. But they're, like... Only those that specific kind. Heathcliff above Dante? That would be hilarious. I think we should do that. You know what? Return of Moe Heathcliff. Let's go. Let's see. And so we said Dante would be like anywhere between 4 and 6 just because everyone else sucks. So probably up here. Oh wait. Let's see. They also mentioned that in Hell's Chicken, Otis wasn't necessarily bad at cooking either, so maybe Otis. I feel like we could put Otis like third or fourth. Let's put her fourth. It's that epic, you know, that epic sergeant moment, epic old lady sergeant moment. She is a hater, but she did mention that she made decent food. I don't know, actually, did she make good food for her soldiers when she was enlisted? Or was she just, like, trashing on Gregor for like, him feeding his bros, canned food? Ishmael and Otis, ship-traveling survivalist food makers. Hell yeah, man! Let's see, you know what? I think we can put her there. And then Heathcliff, with his silly little cream and cucumber sandwiches, he can go there. And then after Otis, I think we could safely put Faust probably there. Just because Faust, she's like, she can do basically everything. I think she would make something that tastes edible. Like, slightly more edible than maybe Sinclair's. She'd be like, yeah, I know what goes in. She'd make a textbook sandwich. It'd be just, like, the most basic thing. Dawn is probably 10. You're so right. Dawn, she would try to make, like, one of those impossible, funny-looking burger things. Like, those ones that are huge, that's, like, more vertical than horizontal. And it's, like, leaking bacon grease or whatever. Actually, I don't think... Would Donkey be a bacon person? I have no idea. But either way, it'd be like one of those crazy American diner burgers. That's like, you have 30 minutes to eat it, and you get to eat here for free for the next 5 years or whatever. She'd try to make one of those burgers, but then it would fail horribly. And it'd just be like this looking thing. We can put Dante at 7. Yeah, probably. Is there anyone who think we go in 5? Dante could, in theory, go in 5, but I don't know. I don't know about these two. Actually, who are we missing? We have Dante, Roja, Sinclair, Honglu. I think we could put Honglu at 9. Respectfully. I don't think Honglu even eats sandwiches. He's probably eaten less sandwiches than Sinclair, who's probably had to have at least eaten one sandwich. So, let's see. Dante... I feel like Dante could go at 5. Maybe. I don't know. Where would Dante go on this list? It's kind of hard to tell now, with these three things specifically. She would make a sandwich, then say, well, peanut butter tastes good. So does chocolate. Pickles aren't a sandwich, right? Now some that sugar. It's fine. I'll add some more salt to even it out. The vegetables look like a salad. Should I add some olive oil? She would make a sandwich like that. That is such a Don Quixote sandwich. Low-key, kind of want to try that. That doesn't sound terrible. I don't like pickles. What am I talking about? What am I talking about that doesn't sound terrible? I hate pickles. Okay. So, you know what? We can compromise. Let's put... What if we'll put Dante right in the middle. Why not? Dante, Faust. I'm missing someone? No. Yes. Okay, now the real question. Would Roja make a better question? No. Would Roja make a better sandwich, or would would Sinclair make a better sandwich? So many upgrades. Kya. Okay. Because, let's see. In Roja's case... Because Sinclair, he has the more defined palate, but also he... Sinclair struggled a lot because the chicken was complicated, but sandwich is simple. True, but also, like, considering, like, his family situation and his, upbringing, it's like, would Sinclair even get the chance to eat sandwiches? Sinclair could figure it out, but I trust Roja. I say Roja would make a bomb-ass sandwich with meat. You're right! You know what? Yeah. Let's see. Let's do that. I think that'll work. Roja can go here. And then Sinclair can go here. This works with my synesthesia. I like that. And so our best our best sandwich making center tier list is officially first place, Mersal, no question. No doubt about it. Number two, in second place, Ishmael. She probably makes like a fish fillet sandwich thing or whatever. She's just that good, you know? Let's do this, Roja. Why not? I say this as if I'm gonna use her. It's just the Liu Association bros. We just figured Ishmael looks like she could make a good sandwich, you know? Something about her. Okay, where do we want to go from here? Many a place we could go. What's a place with, like, the least fighting? pew 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 pew. Pew pew pew. Okay, let's do this. You know what? Yeah, you're right. Would it be a tasty sandwich? I think she could probably make one the fastest. Probably. Do we take speed into account here? Are we taking speed into account here? Or like resourcefulness? Because Ishmael, she could definitely make a sandwich. But would it be a good sandwich? It would be a sandwich. It wouldn't be a bad sandwich. What kind of sandwiches would they make? Marsala would make something super fancy. Like, he doesn't think it's fancy, but it's just, it looks fancy. And then Ishmael. Ishmael's American. She can make like a Philly cheesesteak or something. She like pulls out the Subway knife and she's like, I've got this, guys. Which reminds me, back when I worked at Subway, because I worked at Subway, fun fact, last year. There's this guy who came in, he was real nice. I hated making a sandwich, I won't even lie, but he was real nice. So that's great. Like, I'm a terrible conversationalist, but I could actually hold a conversation with this guy, which was like so real, because I was also using my customer service voice, which is so, it's so annoying sounding. Mer would make something that looks simple, and then you take a bite, and it's like the ratatouille scene with the guy. But the crazy critic guy? So true. I wonder what Marsala thinks about Ratatouille. Ishmael could only make really good fish sandwich, but she hates fish. So she would make good sandwiches she hates. You're right. She's like, she like gives the sandwich to the judge or whoever is like in charge of this supposed sandwich making contest. And they're like, okay, Ishmael, so we watched you the entire time you were cooking, and you didn't once try your food. And she's like, I know, but it tastes good, trust me. And they're like, okay, if you say so. They try it, and then it's another Ratatouille scene. That's the Ishmael sandwich. That's the Ishmael sandwich experience. And then Heathcliff, I don't know, what kind of sandwiches would Heathcliff make? Heathcliff and his... I don't know. Heathcliff sandwiches. I wonder what those would taste like. You know how Greg speaks German on occasion when he's frustrated? I would love to see Merc quietly say the meanest thing in French. You're so right. I don't know any French swear words. I should message my friend who speaks French. Wait, she doesn't like speak French. On the topic of Marsala, he do be dying. It's fine. That just means Lou association isn't as great as they thought they were, and that's why they all died. And ruined up. Ha 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 ha. The downfall of Lou association. Now that Xiao and Lawell are dead. He won sandwich at what cost? If only he had those sandwiches. Right now. But he doesn't. Wait. Okay. Hey, look. Heels. Yay. Convenient. Well, cheers. I love well, cheers. And now it's an abno fight. Let's see. Where was I? I think I was talking about this guy. Oh yeah, so then Subway guy, he was real fun. And then one time he told me about this like series about like American fast food chains, which I think is like, I think it's impressive that America has so many fast food chains. There's like a documentary series about it. But yeah, he mentioned something about like Subway bread or whatever. And I don't even remember what it was. I just remember he talked to me about Subway being on a documentary series about American fast food. And I was like, wow, I work at a Subway. I don't anymore. But yeah, I don't know why I think about that now. God, this win rate button sucks. I really need to stop hitting it. As EGO sweaty, clashes weak, staggers heavy, the multitude tightens its hold, already bongi spaghetti! Oh, you're so right. Where's... These people just be attacking things. Hoi. Okay. I love when the win rate button decides to just not do its thing. Oh well. It be like that sometimes, but it's fine. I think it's funny how we're at 49 minutes into the stream already, and we're not even through Ego Dungeon 1. I'm gonna go insane. Oh. When the win rate button does not win. You're so right. If win rate, why lose? We're HP. We had important business to discuss. Limbus sandwiches. You're so right. What kind of sandwiches would everyone else make? Otis? What would Otis make? She'd make something tasty, probably. And then Faust? Faust would make a very typical, like, turkey sandwich. Faust sandwich? I don't know. What would Faust sandwich be like? Yeah, turkey sandwich with, like, lettuce and tomato and just, like, regular sliced bread. Dante sandwich would also be like Faust sandwich, except a little less tasty. Like, Faust would probably have mayonnaise on it or something. Dante's... No, Faust would have, like, Kewpie mayo on it, and then Dante's would have, like, normal mayo on it. And then Roja, again, with the sweet, like, cream sandwiches. Why did I do that? Why did I do that? That was a real time. She'd be like, manager, what would you like? And Dante don't have a... How does Dante eat? Do they just, like, take the food and, like, singe it on their hair? On their fire hair? Did Dante eat during the chicken kebab scene? I can't remember. That's such an automod moment. And Otis and her old woman strength. So very true. I found this artwork I did like a year ago-ish, roughly. Back when I was still into Genshin. Right, and there's this funny little drawing trend, this funny little meme going around that was like, bye, person X, I'm off to do something. And then person X would be like, not looking like that, you won't. And then they would be like, them in specific pose and be like this. And then person X would be like, yeah, slay. And then, I don't know, at some point I was like in an OC server and I drew that, but with my OC. Imagine playing Genshin, can't be me. AR60. You know, I never actually got to AR60 in Genshin. I'm so proud of myself. I re-downloaded Genshin the other day, in fact. And then I played 15 minutes of it, and I got intimidated, and then I quit the game. So now it's just sitting on this external hard drive that I'm supposed to use for school, and it's just sitting there because I'm scared of the game. There's so much happening in the game. I, like, looked at my quest menu. There were, like, 20 different things, and I was like, I'm never opening Genshin ever again. Y'all streamed 50-50 10 times in a row. How do you do that? That's impressive. Surely in 10 times... I thought that wasn't even possible. Doesn't it, like, if you lose one time, you're, like, guaranteed the next time or something? I have no idea. But that's... That is terrifying. I specifically remember that I got to world level 5 and then back down to world level 4 because I got scared. I felt that so hard, man. I felt that so hard. I don't even know what's going on in Genshin. I know Sumeru just... Am I just released? I mean, I think Sumeru is already, like, what, a year old already? Oh! All the times you didn't have a guarantee, I lost it. Oh! Okay, that makes sense. Okay. That makes sense now. That's a real moment. Man. We need Mark of Cain 2023 luck. Mark of Cain 2023 moment. Wow, this guy's obviously gonna win. Teehee. been Mark of Cain 2023 in a hot minute, in fact. I like looking at this specific boss. It's very Palm Fior. I see people complimenting the lore, but I physically cannot perceive the idea of Genshin being interesting. You're so right. You're so right. I remember I thought Genshin, the lore and the writing, it was so good before Inazuma, and then Inazuma came out and it just like, I don't know what happened to it. I had no idea what was going on at any given moment ever. It was just like, what? Like the Inazuma main story, I was just kind of like, huh? And also like the boss, and the training was harder than the boss, in fact. Oh my god, I'll never forgive that training. I had to switch my party and like metagame my party like 20 different times. Find out like, okay, if I use Mona and I use her sprint, then I'll be able to do this. And if I use Albedo and use the elevator, then I'll be able to avoid this. And like, I don't know, man. That boss, that not even the boss, the training for the boss. It was just, it feels like it's trying to do too much. Yeah, it really does. They really do have cool lore. It's like the whole Archon thing. The Archon thing and the various names, that's a fun concept. I really enjoyed that. Oh, Faust, I dream of you. I dream of you, Kraust. 40 more. I think you do, but I think we are friends, because I've accepted everyone who's tried to add me. It's just, I don't know who anyone is, because, you know, no names, just these. Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo. Please do your best, Ishmael. Purification should be should be okay, I hope. Oh, that's painful. They have the end core too. Handling chicken as usual. Broom broom should suffice, don't you think? Whenever I'm feeling down, I indulge in a bit of Faust. Just wanna be like Bug Guy, that's me. Hey! Hath you seen such clock face? All you can count on now is vroom vroom. Whenever I'm feeling down, I indulge in a bit of Dante. I like how they specifically used that specific Ryoshu. That really adds to the profile message. This real hasn't logged in for a week. Realness. Sorry about that. I'll buy you vroom vroom later. Permission to vroom vroom. Matthew loves vroom vroom. Life is full of questions. I want to be just like Bug Guy. That was a lot of vroom vroom. Okay, we're on dungeon 2 out of 7. We got this. Haven't gone insane just yet. Okay, who do we want to go for now? Let's go with our sandwich makers. Our sandwich makers. So that's Mersault, Ishmael, Heathcliff. Ishmael, Heathcliff. Heathcliff, where are you? 1 hour in. Dungeon 2. We're gonna win. This is great. Look at our sandwich makers. Look at how many Heathcliffs I have. God. What kind of Heathcliff should I use? I'm feeling rabbit Heathcliff. Hoy. Then Ishmael. I hear that she section 5 is pretty good, but I don't use her. I probably should. I should uptie her, in fact. Maybe I'll do that. I can't do that now, but maybe I'll do that after this dungeon. Let's assistant manager so I don't accidentally kill someone. War PTSD and a cool arm that attacks everyone out of control. Sign me up. Yeah. The real Greg experience. Let's see. The route that makes us fight the least, because I cannot be bothered to keep slapping that win rate button or else I will cry real tears. Oh, you know, speaking of Greg, that one Vocaloid song, that one Project Sekai song, I guess it is a Project Sekai song when you think about it, because it was made for the game and stuff. even if like vocal producers, you know what I mean. But that one, Samsa. I thought about covering it for like 5 seconds, and then I was like, the true question, what tier list do we make next? Now that we have our sandwich making sinners, you know, making sandwiches out of these guys, what kind of tier lists are there? It's more like ranking rather than tier list. How should we rank them next? What is there to rank? Who's next on this list? Otis? Otis isn't an option. You know what? It's fine. We don't need them. We don't need them. Go, Greg. I believe in you. We're not using you, Greg, but I believe in you regardless. So after sandwiches, what else is there? Maybe who would lose their mind working in a Subway? I was like, I'm gonna draw so much digital art when I find my pen. Then I remember how much I hate digital art. Dude, I felt that so hard. I couldn't sleep last night, right? Because I slept kind of the entire day yesterday. Because 1, insomnia. 2, internet was out. 3, I don't know, depression. Ranked worst Subway employees. You're right, I have experience on this one. Let's restart this one. How baby girl they are. Let's do that one. Wait. Now the real question. Who is last? I think that's going to be the hardest one. Who would be absolutely last? I don't think we can rank. Can we even rank any of them last in a thing like this? Gregor number 1. You're so right. You're so very right. What do we count Doan as baby girl? Like I feel like you could call her that word, but at the same time, it just wouldn't fit in the connotation it has in the modern online era. Doan is a good old 3/4. Yeah. Let's put Greg. We're also gonna put him in all caps because that's what he deserves. After Greg, who else? Who else is there? I feel like Mersault has to be pretty high up there. Oh, I didn't mean to put. I think Mersault should be high. Imagine hearing that out of context. You know what? I think Mersault should be high in general. Bro is going through it. I almost fell. Fun fact. Okay, Honglu, top 3. You're so right. You know, I see people on Twitter call them the BJ brothers, like those specific 3, so I think it is quite fitting that they're all top 3. Mersault for sure has to be at the very least top 5. Honglu, I feel like Honglu should be 2. He is the fan service character. Like, there's no doubt about it. Bro has a Rose Desire EGO and a whole identity just like with his chest out. He kind of has to be like top 3. Is Yisang baby girl? I don't know. Yisang, he is something. He has the potential to have baby girl energy, I think. I think it's more, he's just beloved in general. He's not necessarily baby girl, you know? Would we consider Ryoshu baby girl? I feel like Ryoshu would be the one calling someone baby girl. He's not baby girl, he's just Yisang. You're so very right. Let's see, what route? This one goes to a hard fight. I don't really like doing hard fights, so I guess. Okay, the entire top. Like a creature I picked up in the woods against my wisdom. Yeah! Yisang gives off cryptid vibes, but not like cryptid vibes. Just kind of like something in the back rooms on like a safe level or whatever. Like when Mersault took his poison yam, he went. I would say that's baby girl behavior, but baby girl behavior doesn't mean he's a baby girl. You're right! So I guess we're not putting Yisang up there. But we definitely have to put Mersault somewhere top five. And maybe Heathcliff. You know what? Let's put Mersault number three. It's what he deserves. It is absolutely what he deserves. I like how for the last one it was easiest to figure out like who was worst. This one it's harder to figure out who is like. It's harder to figure out who's worst. Heathcliff Moe strikes again. Very true. He has to be fourth. Heathcliff. Yeah. But then, where do we want to rank Dante on this list? I feel like, I don't know actually about Dante. Sinclair is not baby girl, but he's so baby girl. I get it. I get it. Dante? I feel like Dante would rank higher than Sinclair. Sinclair would rank... Ooh, where would Sinclair rank? I just know Dante is higher than Sinclair. That is all that we can confirm. Who else is there even? Oh gosh, there's Otis, Ryoshu, Ishmael, Roja, Faust. Dante is baby girl, maybe more than Mersault. Ooh. You're so right. This is hard too because I feel like Roja should be rather high. I don't know how I feel about putting her sixth, but I feel like Dante should be up here. Can we tie them? What if we tied them? You're right. I like how we ranked all the boys top five in baby girlness, but none of the actual girls. Everyone tied for number one. What do you mean everyone tied for number one? Everyone's tied for number two. Nobody can out baby girl Gregor. Oh, Greg. We all love Greg. You know, I saw a bug walking up the stairs. It wasn't even a cockroach. I think it might have been like a moth or something. I saw this moth, I think. I looked at it, and after my like 2 seconds of freaking out because, oh my god, it's a bug. Then I was like, haha, bugs. You know what else is a bug? Greg. Wow, a bug. Cool Limbus Company reference. Exactly. We make one tier and put Greg there. You're very right. You're very right. What if we just most baby girl center other than Gregor? There we go. We fixed it. We fixed it because you cannot outdo the Greg. You cannot outdo him. Which means we have to move everybody up one. Honglu. Then make a third tier and call the third tier Yisei. True. We just do it like one, Gregor. Two, basically everybody else. Three, Yisei. There's baby girl, a socially acceptable baby girl, but so many Limbus companies have so much moe. Yeah, this specific ranking is so much harder. It's so much harder than, oh, why did I go down? Why did I go down? Oh well, that's fine. Oi. Go into the dungeon. There you guys go. Oh no, hand-holding art. Whoa, that's inappropriate. I can't believe you'd say that, hand-holding. Wow, that's so low, man. let's move everybody up one. Do-do-do. Heathcliff. And then after Heathcliff. You're right, Automod. Automod is truly such a silly little thing sometimes, you know? Otis is a gilf. I hate to say it, but you're right. She is. She really is. If we get official age confirmation for Otis and she is like any like under the age of 40, I will scream. Let's see. This is really a difficult list. Whew. So true. She is at the very least middle-aged, but like the older edge of middle-aged. Milder made me think of Milgram. I'm so sorry. Roja 4. Oh, you're right. Roja can go here, and then let's put Dante here. I think that's what they deserve. I think that those are pretty good placements for our first five. Who goes after this? That's the real question. Otis throws her umbrella up in the air and then proceeds to snap her back. Oh my gosh. Otis comes out of like the funny little pocket universe with all their cabins and whatever. It's like, good evening, youngins. I've made cookies. Speak of the devil, it's Otis. Yay. I think Sinclair's more baby than just baby girl. Yeah. I think Otis would rank higher than Sinclair on this list. I'm not even gonna lie. Okay, what is the best route for this? I'll just maybe go down all the way? Grandma Otis is 4-star. She exists there somewhere. Truth. I don't have almost all the sinners in my arsenal. Otis for number 6? You know, I can vibe with that. Yeah. Otis. Otis isn't baby girl, is she? Would you really say so? Is there anyone who would rank higher than her, though? Maybe Dawn. I don't know. How do you feel about Dawn? Where would she go? Donkey. I feel like Donkey also ranks higher than Sinclair. Who even is left? We have, other than Sinclair, there's Donkey, there's Yiseng. But we already kind of decide Yiseng is last, again. Just because he's like this third mysterious thing. Like, in the binary of not baby girl and baby girl, Yiseng is Yiseng, man. Ishmael is lower than Sinclair. You're right. So Ishmael lower than Sinclair, Otis higher than Sinclair, Donkey, I feel like, should be higher than Sinclair. They need to be young, hence the baby. She is a grandma, so she can't be baby girl. Oh, that's a good point. That is a good point. Oh. In that case, do we move her down one? This is such a dilemma. You know what, I'm gonna put the ones we don't have here. There's Yoshu, Ishmael, Sinclair, Faust, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who am I forgetting? Who am I forgetting? We did Greg already. Oh my god, I'm blanking out. I'm forgetting. Oh wait, Donkey. That's what I'm forgetting. Typing. Donkey. Fun fact, my typing speed is like 110 words per minute. Teehee. Where's Obvious? There's Obvious. Okay. So, Faust and then Otis. I can. That sounds good. So I guess Faust, Otis, And then... So, I say... Faust goes there. I know one person who might compete with Gregor on the BBG scale. Who? Who could compete with Gregor? Who? Would it be Honglu? Virgin... That one's canon. That one's like literally canon. That like... He's the only one who can compete. But Virgilius isn't a sinner, so it doesn't count. Let's snuff out the candles. Skill final power 1, minus 1, that's whatever. Okay. Virgil isn't a sinner. It's okay. Gregor stays 1. But if it was... But if we did include Virgil would absolutely... would absolutely pummel Greg. Or at least tie with him. So then... Our last 4. So Ishmael, lower than Sinclair. Donkey, I say, higher than Sinclair. Ryoshu is somewhere on that scale. I feel like Ryoshu also has to be higher than Sinclair. Even if she's kind of a mess, even if it feels like she'd probably kill you if you dare say she is baby girl, I feel like we could put Ryoshu kind of like right after Donkey. Maybe. Donkey, Ryoshu, Sinclair, Ishmael. Yeah. I don't know, I feel like in the case of Sinclair and Ryoshu, it's kind of difficult. Sinclair's maracas. You're right, man. Sinclair's not baby girl, he's just pathetic boy. Very true. He's my fave. My favorite cringe fail loser boy. The cringe fail loser boy. One could say. Sinclair and Ryoshu. It's like if you put baby girl in the middle, like Ryoshu, like if you say you had a line, say like line. It's like on this side of the line, on this side would be Ryoshu, and then on this side would be Sinclair. They are both extremely far from... They're both far from baby girl, but in, like, different directions. You know? Ryoshu and Yusang both fall under not baby girl. Not baby girl. Secret worst thing. Now that I think about it, Sinclair has an amazing weapon choice. He can use the hat to hide his face when crying and use the maracas as noise... to noise out the tears. If only he could have done that during the Cromer fight. Alas. He couldn't. Poor guy. So then... this part. I forgot which one was the good one to pick. I think it was paper. Yeah, paper! Woo! These last 4, they are difficult. Whoever would we pick? I think we can safely say probably that Ishmael's going 11th. Probably. Ishmael, you can go there. Why not? And then what else? So then yeah, she's too sane. She's too American to be baby girl. She's got that sailor swag to her, you know? What if we just say Ryoshu and Sinclair tie? No, that'd be weaseling out of it. We're not weaseling out of this. It's Ryoshu and Sinclair. Whoever will get here. Sinclair? Yeah. There's a lot of evidence. You've presented a lot of arguments towards Sinclair 9. There we go.
And now we've got our most baby girl center other than Gregor list. She does have her moments. I love her. I personally think that knife moment in Kanto 2, I think that's a good moment. That was a real Roshu baby girl moment, you know? So, our most baby girl center other than Gregor list is Hongwu. Oh wait, I should probably delete the four at the bottom now that we've actually sorted them. Oopsie. Choo 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 choo. Hoo hoo. Oh. Hoo. Okay. And so, our list. Number one, Hong Lu. Without a doubt, Hong Lu. Hong Lu and his Rose 8 Desire EGO. Hong Lu and his. Which one was it? The Kudo Kumo? The clan one? This tier list will put Twitter in war. Oh my gosh. Is this how I get canceled? the Limbus Company baby girl tier list? This is gonna be how I get canceled. As a streamer. I cannot remember the answers for this one. I'm just gonna press things. Yeah, I cut the cables was right. Okay. Choose an ampoule. You know, I did get canceled on Twitter one time because I said something about Paradox Life. It's always Paradox Life. It's kind of funny. By kind of funny, I mean I deactivated my account. no. Not- this was like in November. My most recent deactivation was simply because the mental illness be mental illnessing. Teehee. Ahem. Anyways. It's always Paradox Life. It really is always Paradox Life. Bro. That series makes me like the other day I was like, I don't think I'm gonna get a ticket to the dope show stream. I'll probably just ignore it. And then I saw like 4 seconds of Visti live and I was like, I love Visti. yeah, the anime trailer, oh my god, it was so I loved it so much. It was so cute. I'm so excited for the Paradox Life anime because now I can actually get my friends into it without having to relay all of the plot points to them. Want to get canceled super fast? Say, I don't think Elon did a good job with the recent update. So right. Oh, Twitter is a mess. It's been a mess for like the past year. But Paradox Life anime. Pine Jam is such a good studio. I've only watched like 2 things by them. Actually, not even 2 things. I watched Gleipnir. That was it. Gleipnir itself was kind of. But the animation was great. And then I watched like 1 episode of Do It Yourself. And I was like, wow, that's great too. Yeah! Oh my god, Cosmos plot. I'm so excited to see their phantoms animated. Especially Shiki's. Because, you know, he's got the whole thing going on. I don't even know what's going on with him, but he's got a thing going on. Oh, him and his supposedly largely breasted Grim Reaper. Not EGO. I said the word earlier. What was the word again? It's not EGO. Phantom. The Paradox Live brain is slowly being infested by the Limbus brain. It's a curse. Limbus Company is a curse. I just realized I don't have my stream labels open, and my thing didn't update. Yeah. Next Mirror Dungeon, you know what time it is. New tier list. You're right. Next thing. Here we are. Hem. Toot. I guess we're just gonna go with like the top 3 from the past tier list. Get to be the ones who are stuck with fighting. So Honglu Mersault. So Honglu Mersault Heathcliff. I think we've used Mersault like every single time. It's kind of funny. Poor guy. Guy needs a break. Worst subway employee.
Wee, mouse fell.
Yeah. The Limbus Pass, I think it's pretty worth it. I don't say that about battle passes, but Limbus Pass, I think it's pretty good. I won't even lie. Okay, let's once we figure out our route, we're gonna start the list. Here they be. It's the PJ Bros. Worst would be a tie between Heathcliff, Ryoshu, and Greg. I think Ryoshu and Greg, they would be a health hazard, both of them. Heathcliff, even though he's a great sandwich maker, he is not a customer service man. Someone's head is getting bashed in, and that specific subway is getting sued. Speaking of sued, do we call it Subway? Worst sandwich shop employee. We're gonna do that just because. Way sub. You're right. Way sub. Way sub. Employee. The real W core. Way sub. And then let's delete all of these guys. They don't exist anymore. Boop. Boop. Now we do this 12 more times. Oh yeah, we need to add the 13 on top of it. Real question, who would be the best way sub employee? Who is out there, like, doing their best every day, even though they're only getting paid $11 an hour plus tips? Ryoshu first? Let's see. Ryoshu second. She would poison them. Heathcliff first. Greg can manage a third, since all the ingredients are there. Wait, so. Ryoshu would poison and then kill the customer for not enjoying her art. Heathcliff is the anti-customer service. I think his pure rage would defeat Ryoshu's blatant poisoning. Say Otis. I want to say Otis also. Otis easily. Yeah. Otis. Good job, Otis. Otis would be tryharding that thing every day. Staying, like coming on her days off. Otis is truly the subway employee ever. I mean, the way sub employee ever. So then I guess the first two, I guess it's a battle between Ryoshu and Heathcliff. Heathcliff being British and angry, and Ryoshu being Ryoshu. I feel like Heathcliff would try to make the thing right, but Ryoshu would be like, you want buffalo sauce? I think that's bad. That's terrible. You're getting ranch. I'm gonna put Ryoshu there just because even if Heathcliff would start like throwing knives at people, I think they would at least get to like the bread part. He would, like, start cutting the bread, and then the customer would say something stupid. The customer would be like, actually, I asked for a 6-inch, not a foot long. And then that's when Heathcliff starts chucking knives. But then, in the case of Ryoshu, they'd be like, I asked for a foot long, not a 6-inch. And then Ryoshu's like, shush, we're getting a 6-inch, no matter what you say. Ryoshu just starts drawing like smiley faces, not even smiley faces, just like dead bodies on their thing. And then like she gets reported to management and she's fired like her second day there. Second day is being generous. She is fired her first hour being there. You think finally gets to get a high tier with this list? I voted for 3. Oh, you're right. He'd like put out the expired food because it like tastes okay. Not even tastes okay. He didn't even taste it. He was just like, that looks like you could put it in your mouth, you know?
And then he'd put it out, and then someone would scream at him and be like, oh my god, there's bugs crawling on it. But Heathcliff, I mean, not Heathcliff, Yuseng, I think when it comes to just anything that isn't prepping the ingredients, he could try. So Yuseng, you can go here. And then, when we think about it, Greg wouldn't be that bad of an employee, you know? Greg, even if he's technically a living health violation, he would try. Greg can be four. The main reason why he's not working is simply just because he's a health violation. And then after Greg, I kind of want to say Donkey, because we saw her in K-Core. We saw her in K-Core. She sees someone, like, a customer that's slightly entitled. Actually, no. Donkey? Where would Donkey go? I feel like Donkey, it really depends. You could see her as both, like, the best ever or, like, the worst ever. Yeah, you don't need to be able to cook, because you're really not cooking anything there. You're just, like, folding turkey, cutting tomatoes. He can do that. He can do, at the very least, that much. But when it comes to, like, anything else, it's like anything cooking, but you don't do cooking, he'd be fine. Like, he just shouldn't be there. I think Donkey would probably... God, this is hard. Where would Donkey be? Would Donkey be higher than Gregor or lower than Gregor in this case? Because Greg would try. Number four, Dante. Dante? How would Dante fare at sandwich shop? Where are we going with this one? Two. I guess we're going here. 싱싱한 풀이 보이네. Speak. I kind of forgot about that. I won't even lie. I kind of completely forgot about that. But also, think about this. If customer wants their bread toasted, they don't even have to like put the bread in the oven. They could just like hold it above their head for a bit. Actually, that would probably pose a safety hazard too. Yeah, the customer just has to speak, but at the same time, if it comes to, like, a difficult customer, then Dante is kind of screwed. I don't know, Dante... I feel like Dante, like, customer service-wise, it'd be kind of awful for them. But, like, in terms of actually making the thing, I feel like they'd be competent enough. I'd say Dante would be in the middle-ish. Dante can't make a situation worse if the customer can't speak to them. See, here's the thing about customers at sandwich shop. even if you don't say anything, they will still yell at you because many of the people who came to the one I worked at were old. I don't know the general demographic for this specific sandwich chain, but the one I worked at, like, most of our customers were well above the age of, like, 55. And the young people who did come, anyone, who, like, under the age of 18 who came, they were all entitled prissy rich kids. like, let's see. There's this group of 16-year-olds who ordered a Mexican pizza from Taco Bell or something. And then... proceeded to smoke in the bathroom and also flood the bathroom, which really sucked because it was just me and like one other guy there, and it was just not a fun time. What else? There was this other group of kids. They were like, what, 10, 11 years old. They would constantly like beg us for free things, but not in a like they needed it way, and also that, like, those kids, like, would steal things. They were actually banned from the shop, fun fact. Maybe it was just the area also, because
very much, it is a very middle class area, so just many of the children are pretty spoiled. Speaking of prissy rich kids, Sinclair would just start crying at the first slightly difficult customer. I did that my third day. Fun fact. I like broke down in front of a bunch of customers. That is like 6 to 8. The others are definitely worse than them. Yeah. I think we could... Dante would be like safe. A safe 7. Let's put the lightning shaped button. We'll put Dante as 7. I feel like Sinclair would be slow and he would just not be having a good time. Let's put Sinclair... You know what? I feel like we could put Sinclair at 5. He gets to take Donkey's place. And then Dante can go here. And then Faust... I think we can safely say Faust would be at like 12. Faust is Faust. What more can I say about that? Faust is Faust. Yeah, Faust knows all. Who else is there? There's Ishmael. She might get difficult with a customer. Ishmael, Roja. Roja, I think, would be okay, probably. Ishmael, Roja. Who else? Honglu. Honglu, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, Dante. Dante. No, I think we could put Dante here. No. Honglu here. Honglu goes here. Honglu goes there. Donkey goes there. Dante just keeps rising up. Honglu would just... No. Actually, yeah, Honglu would be slightly better than Sinclair. I feel like Honglu would be better at, like, doing things. Would be slightly faster than Sinclair at doing things. When it comes to customer service, he'd just kind of be a mess. Tick tock tock. Faust, they're asking what you'll order. Tick tick, cash or credit. Horn noises. Would you like to order the affordable menu for $2.99 off your order? Faust will not allow you to make such a simple mistake. The correct choice is obviously the affordable menu. You are getting that. Just for that, I think we could move Faust up to 11. Yeah, and because Mersault also exists, we're moving Faust to 11. We're moving Faust to 11, we have to. Can I click on the thing? Oh, it's the other way. Yay, healing! Oh wait, not healing. Center recruitment! Yay! and then boss, then we can put Mersault, Fausti, and then Ishmael is logical enough, but she also gets mad, so she's just a normal person working customer service. The real American experience. The real American fast food worker experience. That really is Ishmael. A bomber? Where would Cromer be? Oh no! Cromer, where would Cromer be? Assuming Cromer is a sinner. Let's assume Cromer is the 14th sinner. No idea why she would be there, but that's the current scenario we're going with. Where would she be? Oh, dearie. Okay. I meant to say geez, and then I meant to say dearie, and then I said jeery. I think that's a word. Like, jeer? Jeer, that's a word. No, I think I'm mixing that up with leer. I have no idea, man. Words are dumb. She'd be like grandpa levels of technology knowledge. True, she'd probably burn herself on the oven or something. Or like, struggle with the cash register. I think she'd more just freak out the customers. She's the evil messed up branch owner. She is the manager of this establishment. It's not Dante, it is Cromer. 1, 2, 3. And then,
What other ones are there? One, two. I guess we're going with top row completely. Sure, why not? That was number 10, Ishmael 11. That works. Yeah. Faust is here. Oh god, who are we forgetting? Ishmael here. Yeah! Who is the last person? Oh my god. Me and Brain won't brain. Oh, Roja! Roja, she's just like a little bit like airheaded, but she would get the job done. You know? She would push what she thinks is best onto others. Yeah. Okay. You know what? I like this list. I think this is a pretty sound list. It's the worst way sub employee. First, Roshu. 100%. She's poisoning people. And on top of poisoning people, she's not even making your order right. She'd charge you like $3 extra because she's like, you should get 3 cookies. And the customer would be like, but I don't want 3 cookies. And she's like, no, you have to get 3 cookies with this sandwich. And the customer's like, I'm allergic to ingredients in your cookies. And she's like, you are taking these cookies and you are paying for them. And that's the Roshu experience. And the cookies, by the way, are completely burnt and taste like smoke. Number 2, Heathcliff. You get past the bread and he just goes absolutely bonkers. Would Roja be higher? Would she be higher? I think... That 7-8-9 section. She puts the cookies in the sandwich. True. I think that 7-8-9 section is debatable. Donkey, Dante, Roja. I feel like Donkey might be a little bit better. Dante has the whole not being able to talk thing. I'm gonna switch Dante and Donkey, actually. She would get in beef because she doesn't want to throw away food after the day and wants to give people extra food. Oh, okay. That makes sense. In that case, we could probably move her... Oh, in that case, though, she and Donkey would kind of be the same. So I think we could probably keep her there. Or... No, we could probably switch her and Dante. Oh. She would throw... Yeah, I feel like she would throw a fit about it. Like, it really does suck because that's a real fast food moment. But at the same time, it's like... Man... Corporations. Should cut off the head of prissy rich kids who clog the toilet. Yeah. Yeah, she would. Donkey and Dante. I think we should. Yeah, we could swap them. What if we just say, like, those three just tie? Oh, we can't say that. But in my head, they tie. I can't believe we're only on dungeon, what, 3? Dante, Donkey. Donkey. At least Donkey would... Donkey, I feel like, would read the handbook. Donkey would know the rules the slightest bit better. Donkey would be higher than Hong Lu. Really? You know what? Yeah, I guess. Because Hong Lu is sheltered, but... that entire, like, 6 to 9 section... I'm sorry. That entire 6 to 9 section is debatable. Yeah. So you think about it... Hong Lu would probably do something funny or accidentally insult someone. Donkey would start a fight. Hong Lu wouldn't start a fight. Oh, in terms of actually working, I did put Hong Lu like below Sinclair because I was sort of like viewing them the same. Because it was like Sinclair would suck and would start crying and like would not know what to do or how to handle like fast food restaurant. Yeah.
Someone would start a fight with Hong Lu, Donkey would start a fight with someone. Like, there are fights going on, but the causes are different. That's what's going on. Aww, bro, our Heathcliff died. First death, yeah, let's go. Notice how he's number two on this list. For now, perhaps, I'd say we could keep this list as it is. Unless someone is super against something. Because just that general 6 to 9 section is a mess. You're like, wow, this is interesting. This reminds me of the time I used to feed all the dogs in our house. Oh, the food was better, though. He would say that. I think some of the customers, they could take that as like a joke, though. Oh my god. Speaking of dead people, what the fuck? Respectfully? What? Was the win rate button not doing its thing again? I don't think it was doing its thing again. Oh, and there's bleed. And there's bleed. Honglu carrying. Honglu dying. Honglu dead. This is a real moment, you know? Real baby girl moment. It's okay. We have these three. Yeah, I should have paid more attention to the background. Win rate button. Teehee. There's no way I'm gonna lose a mirror dungeon. This is a real moment. Actually, does it still count as doing the mirror dungeon even if I die? We're already staggered. We've staggered the old lady. Slay, literally, yeah. For some reason, reading that just now, like reading the word slay next to Roja with like all the red in the background, that made me think of Hypnosis Mike. Because of the Chuoku girlie's solo songs and what's her face? I don't remember her name. The one with like light brown hair whose like chest is very much out there. Kari no Koji? Is that her name? Someone soloed Chroma with bass Roja. Oh my god. I feel like soloing Chroma at this point is just a thing everyone has to do now. I need to do that. I haven't soloed her properly yet. I need to figure out how to do that. I'll go into the game plan one day and just be like, hi, Chroma. Whoa. I think it's so funny how Waysub was the end of this specific mirror dungeon. Which one was this one? This was like third, right? But does it count? Girly could not slay. Girly got slayed. Toot. I hope that counted. If it didn't count, I would cry. So we started at 23. So it should be at 26 if we're lucky. And if we're not lucky, I will cry. I counted! Wait, this means I could just like go in with base sinners and lose all of them. And it would still count. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Who are we going in? Way Sub Employee Edition. Ryoshu, Heathcliff, Yisang. Let's go. Ryoshu, Heathcliff, Yisang. Yay! And they're just gonna go in like that. Death speed run. It's gonna hurt my ego, but it's okay. It's for the greater good. It's for those five extra battle pass points. Anyways, since we're on dungeon 4, you know what that means? Dungeon 4? Not just Way Sub employees, but specifically the Way Sub failures. Yeah. This is their punishment for being such terrible employees.
New tier list time. What is our new list? What is our new ranking? Whatever could it be?
I need to get water. Oh wait, there's water in front of me.
How Filipino are they? Just kidding. They are all Filipino. That's why we can't rank them on Filipino-ness. Because they're all Filipino. I had an idea at one point, and then I forgot it when we when Waysub list. Otis number one. Otis is the Filipino. Kissing up to everyone. Subtly, but not so subtly, insulting everyone at the same time. She is the Filipino ever. And in terms of Filipino-ness, I think next would be Donkey for, you know, Spain. I just think also she's very loud, very, very fun laugh. Likes to jump into things. Very extroverted. Very extroverted. Donkey is the Filipino. Those two. They are the Filipinos of Limbus Company. Like the extra Filipinos of Limbus Company. Who else? I mean, what else? What other silly tier lists are there? Tier list ideas. Kids tier list. Who could take care of kids? Oh my god. You know what's funny? You know what? That fits. My baby cousin is over. Baby cousins. There's two of them. Babysitting tier list. Babysitting. It's more like a ranking. We'll do rankings. Would we trust Otis with kids? I feel like she'd probably make them cry. She'd be like, what do you mean you don't know what a Pythagorean theorem is? It's just a squared plus b squared equals c squared. And then the kid starts crying because the kid is like six and is just barely understanding basic addition. Let's see, best babysitter ranking. Sitter. Roja, 100%. Sinclair is the baby. Sinclair is not babysitting anyone. Sinclair is dying. I think the kids, they would like Yi-Sang's Yi-Sang puns. Otis would be an ROTC instructor. Otis would just start making them cry. Oh, what? Wait, that's kind of fun. You know, I almost pursued teaching and then I didn't. Wish I did, but I never did. What? The kid, yeah, Sinclair's getting bullied. Poor guy. Like, what can he do? He can pull out, like, some circuitry and be like, hey guys, this is how batteries work. And then they just, like, start bullying him and they eat the batteries. Donkey! Oh my god, yeah, Donkey. She had rank pretty high. Hold on. Greg has to be there. Like, literally in canon, he has a sister. Like, Greg has to be, at the very least, top five. Like, Broman literally has a sister. And in... But, like, by that logic, we could put Sinclair higher because he does canonically have two sisters in the original book. But they barely get brought up, and I also think they're older. So actually, Sinclair, you're gonna continue to be babied. Oh my god! Rotigor, oh my god. I love them. They're so real. Sinclair, at the very least, he has to be in the double digits on this list. He is not going down here. Oh, you're right. Donkey would... I feel like they would like her, but the parents would not like her. Like, they come back, and the entire house is trashed. The kids have mud on their face. They look like they had a great time, but the poor parents... would be surprisingly competent. I think I trust her. Do you? Oh. Roshu is absolutely not. Like, listen. Otis would keep them safe. Roshu would probably start chasing them around with a knife or something. Roshu is absolutely not in single digits. Yeah, I do not trust Roshu around children. Like, you leave her with three of them, two of them are making it out alive. Oh wait, true, okay. Huh. You know, I have hell screen somewhere in my room right now. What if I, like, read it really fast? Marsalt's pure autistic swag would have, like, 50 kids hanging off him, and he'd be unbothered, and they would have the time of their lives. You know what? I can see that. I can see that, at least. How are we gonna go about this? I guess straight and then up? Yeah, straight up. I say this as if I'm not, like, intentionally making them die. I think we could rank Marsalt high. I mean, he has to deal with Donkey every day, so he's already ranking pretty high in my book. He thinks audio would appeal to kids. They think he's funny. Yeah! I think Dante would start panicking, so I think I would put Dante around, like, wherever we're putting Sinclair. I think Ishmael would be stressed. Heathcliff? I mixed up his vowels. Heathcliff, I feel like he would not have a good time. We can put Ishmael next. Ishmael. Heathcliff, I don't think Heathcliff is making it out alive. I won't even lie. And then probably Faust. Faust would work. We're speed running this one. So then Sinclair, Hong Lu. I think kids would like Hong Lu. I don't think he'd know how to watch them per se, but I think they would like him. We should probably, I think we could move, let's see, Discord me. Me when I'm blind. There it is. Whoa! Hell screen stuff. What do we do when people are mean? Kill them. That's right. Tell your classmates your mom is the best artist in the city. And if they're mean to you again, I'll kill their families. Okay. Imagine the most responsible person in the city is a chain-smoking mass murderer. Just based off that alone, I think we could put Roshu higher. Yeah. I'm taking your word for this just because I haven't read Hellscreen myself. Let's see. Also, I'm putting Heathcliff, like, right there then. So I guess Roshu probably... Where would Roshu go then? In that case. Listen! Otis is making them kids cry. She is forcing them to do their math homework. Like, I feel like the parents, if they are strict parents, they would love her. If they are normal parents, they'd be like, why would you make our kids cry? I get that they have to do their homework, but she is, like, signing them up for Kumon as, like, while the parents are gone. So then, you know what? What if I do read Hellscreen? I know the book is somewhere in this room. Somewhere. Kumon sucked, man. I will say that right now. I don't remember much of it. I just remember it sucked. Where's the book? Apparently it was on my desk somewhere. So, I feel like the Roshu, as we know her now,
As we know her now, she would not be a good parent. Not parent, babysitter. At least with Greg, based off his interactions with Yuri, and also just how he interacts with, like, the younger ones, like Sinclair, I don't think he'd be terrible. Where are we going? We are going next one, and then those two. Why are they still alive? Yeah, I'll put Roshu, just, if we're going off lore too, like source material, I'll put her 8th. Why not? Actually, yeah, I'll put her 8th. And then Honglu, I'll put Honglu where Ishmael is. Honglu. I'm like kind of completely changing this actually. Ishmael, we can put her 9th. She'd be kind of pissed. She's used to, like, really scary sailor bros, you know? Sinclair is not going to be high. So sorry, Sinclair. And then Dante, they can't understand Dante, so Dante can go there. And somehow it's already finished. Wow, crazy. A few people saying that Roshi's sword is her daughter's makes sense. Because the sword is a universal constant. Oh, okay. You know what? What page is Hellscreen on in the book? Chronology. Notes. Introduction. Where's the table of contents? I know I should definitely read the introduction stuff first so I can get better context, but for now. Oh, and there's a translator's note. Wow, crazy. Under the sword, modern trash comedy. Gregor's own story. Notes. World in decay. Shomon. Where is the table of contents? Did I skip over it? Oh, I did. Okay. 42. Page 42. Where are we? Hellscreen. Even Chef Ryoshu has a sword, yeah. She's been able to try it, but she's stressed and awkward, and they can tell. Yeah, she kind of just like sit around, and they'd be like, Ishmael, can we play? Ishmael, can we watch TV? She'd be like, your parents said no. And they'd be like, but I want to watch TV. And she'd be like, well, they said no. They'd be like, please, Ishmael? And they just like would not stop bothering her, but she's like not sure if she should let them or not. You know? Ooh, this guy. Grab the hand. I don't think I was supposed to do that. Can't remember. Oh, we lost SP. But we got a thing. Yay! Where's the part where they die? I love the part where I was like, hey, I'm gonna... Since... It counts still if I just put them in there, then even if they die, we can just go with their base identity since I don't have them like, you know, but they're surprisingly competent. Like overly competent. You know, I actually haven't seen their base attacks. This is fun to watch. Let them go. Yeah, F him up. Heathcliff? Okay, Hellscreen. How many pages is this? 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay, 42 to... Seems pretty... Okay. 42 to 73, so roughly 31 pages. In theory, I could just, like, do it right now. In theory. It is kind of thick, though. That's cool. That's cool, man. Honestly, considering it's 9:04 a.m., I think I should probably maybe also head off soon. Even though I said I would finish my Mira Dungeons I might finish them at reset or something. I think I will finish them at reset. Because that's in 5 hours. And I would still... Yeah, that's in 5 hours. It's fine. Where is... Okay, best route. I don't want to do double battles. Actually, might make them die faster. But they don't seem intent on dying, so maybe not. Why didn't I pick... Thingy... Zwei, I think? Zwei Association? Sinclair, why did I do that? Oh well. 1, 2, 3... Yeah, whatever. It's 3, no matter how you look at it. Here we are. Okay, yeah. I think after this one, I might leave, perhaps. Because 9:05 a.m, the day is starting to start. Yeah. And I can do the final 3 after the week resets in 5 hours. And then I'll get my funny little ego shard things. And then maybe I can get Kraust, but probably not. I want Kraust so bad. Given her story is about an artist who goes mad trying to depict hell at the bequest of his lord, who he pissed off because he's trying to stop the lord from forcibly taking his daughter as his mistress and ends up unwittingly burning her alive by the lord's machinations. I wonder if her thing is going to be that she pissed off the finger somehow, and in punishment she was made to kill her own kid. Her being a parent would explain her really bad puns too. They're just misplaced dad jokes from Reddit, because Reddit seems to be obsessed with shit. That's one way to look at it. You know what? If I'm gonna end soon, I might as well. Welcome to my reading out loud session. If I had other people here, we could start popcorn reading. But it's just my voice. You're all stuck with my voice. It's gonna be like those really bad sessions in English class where everyone has to read out loud and then the teacher makes you pause. ASMR, I read a bedtime story. Welcome to my ASMR stream. Today we're reading Hell Screen by Ryunosuke Akutagawa. God, imagine an actual ASMR stream for me. That would be terrible. Hey! Corrosion, let's go! We might get through our 4th run faster than I thought we would. Yeah! I love it when Yusang corrodes. That is Yusang, right? Who corroded just now? I think that is. It's so nice when he corrodes. I don't know, all of his corroded forms look so fun. Where was I? Yeah, imagine an ASMR session for me. That would be terrible. I can't take myself seriously half the time. I say something and I'm like... I guffaw after. I did just now. I just cannot take myself seriously. I just realized it's Roja time, whoa. Because two of them are dead and I just clicked on a random one. Okay, you know what, let's go this way. Why not? What if we just sent Yusang there with his negative 45 SP? What would happen? I'm just gonna make everyone solo things. Hope they die. Anyways, right, Hell Screen. I hope I don't get like sued or anything. I tried to do audiobooks one time. It didn't work out. But that's besides the point. Hem. Page 1. I'm certain there has never been anyone like our great lord of Horikawa, and I doubt there ever will be another. In a dream before his lordship was born, our maternal ladyship saw the awesomely armed guardian deity of the West. West? Why did I say that? Say it like that. He can't corrode if he's staggered. Ayy. Or so people say. In any case, his lordship seemed to have innate qualities that distinguished him from ordinary human beings. And because of this, his accomplishments never cease to amaze us. You need only glance at his mission in the capital's Horikawa district to sense the boldness of its conception. It's... how shall I put it? Its grandeur, its heroic scale are beyond the reach of our mediocre minds. Some have questioned the wisdom of his lordship's undertaking such a project, comparing him to China's first emperor, whose subjects were forced to build the Great Wall, or to the Sui Emperor Yang, who made his people erect lofty palaces, but such critics might be likened to the proverbial blind man who described the elephant according only to the parts they could feel. It was never his lordship's intention to seek splendor and glory for himself alone. He was always a man of great magnanimity. That's a word. Listen to Just by Sinclair. See what happens. I hope he dies fast. He probably won't, considering he's the one non-base ID. Or maybe he will. I believe in you. I believe in you, Sinclair. Please die for our sake. Surely this is why he was left unscathed by his encounter with that midnight procession of goblins so often seen at the lonely intersection of Nizo Omiya in the capital. It is also why, when rumor had it that the ghost of Toru, minister of the left, was appearing night after night at the site of his ruined mansion by the river at Higashi Sanjo, you must know it, where the minister had recreated the famous seascape of Shiogama in his garden, it took only a simple rebuke from his lordship to make the spirit vanish. There's a bunch of notes. Where are these notes? There's already been like two. It's fine. We can look at them later. In the face of such resplendent majesty, no wonder all residents of the capital, old and young, men and women, revered his lordship as a reincarnation of the Buddha. Yes, he's dead! Let's go! That has nothing to do with the book. I'm talking about Sinclair. He's dead. Okay. Let's send both of these in at the same time. Hopefully they die fast. And if they don't, then I might cry a little bit. I won't even lie. It's dungeon 4. You know, I lasted longer than I thought I would. I thought I would start, like, banging my head on the wall about, like, 40 minutes ago. That's my prediction, right? 8:30. But it's 9. It's, like, 9 already. And I'm already... And I haven't started banging my head on the door. The door is across the room. I meant wall. Although I did start reading house screen. So, maybe... Maybe the insanity isn't manifesting as a physical reaction. What is she fighting with? I just noticed that. What is Roja fighting with? Some kind of axe? Oh yeah, an axe. The tearless saved the day. You're right! She's staggered. Donkey staggered. Roja has got that 105 HP. Oh dear, where did I leave off? Yeah, it's an axe. I couldn't tell at first because from the fighting animation, but it very much is an axe, yeah. And I also was like thinking, I was like, oh wait, she uses an axe in her story. Oh, that's why it's an axe, yay! This makes me realize I don't know some of their base weapons. Yeah! I love that part of the story. I loved it when Roja said, it's Roja time, and Roja'd all over everyone. They're dead! Let's go! We got through a whole, like, page of hell screen. A whole page and a third of hell screen. Wow. I should probably finish reading it later. Considering I've already started it, it's only 31 pages. It's over. Thank you. And now I just wait until restart. Until the weekly restart to the dungeon again. And then once I dungeon again, I can get my Kraust. Roja, that art was scary. She was. Maybe when my mouse, what mouse? What do you mean Limbus Company not responding? Respond. My Limbus Company isn't Limbus Company-ing. This is the first time it's ever given me the not responding message, fun fact. This is truly a moment. It didn't like me intentionally trying to die. Aww. You know what? It's fine. It's fine. No, it's not. How does this happen? Computer cited, that's enough Limbus for today. True. 2 hours of Mirror Dungeons is enough to go to make anyone go insane, whether you're a computer or you're a human. I guess this is the part where I go on my 20-minute long speech. Spiel. Not speech. My 20-minute long spiel about how... about announcements and whatever. Okay. What is there to say? I covered Null from Cloquista. I'm premiering that on what's it called? Sunday. Yeah. I'll probably try and stream tomorrow to make up for the lack of a stream yesterday. Yeah. I don't know what I'll stream tomorrow though, so it might be Twisted Wonderland. Probably not gonna be an art stream because I don't know what to draw. I mean, I do know what to draw. It's just kind of embarrassing drawing, so I'd rather color. But I don't have anything to color. Speaking of drawing, I figured the other day I should try and make like one of them VTuber rooms, because VTuber rooms are so fun, you know? But then I remembered, I don't have money, and not only that, I don't know how to do backgrounds. So what I did, this morning, and by this morning I mean like 3 a.m. So what I did at 3 a.m. was I went onto Roblox because I was like, yay, I'm gonna open Bloxburg and make a room there. And then I realized my computer had no storage, apparently. And so then I spent like 3 hours trying to clear it out. And then I went on Bloxburg and then I made the room. And then I'm like gonna sort of trace over it, but not really. I'm gonna at least use it as a base. See if I can make backgrounds. I don't do backgrounds. So yeah. But that's besides the point. Other things to announce. Yeah, I got nothing other than Null Premiere Sunday. Tensu and I's collab moved to next Tuesday. Yeah. That's pretty much it. Should follow me on TikTok and Twitter. Mostly TikTok though, because that's where all my what's it called? Bleh. Is the network networking again? Bro. Blah. Okay, I don't know. TikTok's where I post all my fan service and everything that has to do with my like live 2D model before I actually make my live 2D model debut. Whoa. Yeah. What else is there to say? Yeah, that's pretty much it, really. Basic stuff. If you really want to know everything that's going on with me, just look at the ends of my last VODs. Yeah. I think it's good now. Yeah. I hope so. Okay. Well, we're about to end anyway, so that's okay. Yay! So, yeah. If you liked this, if you're watching this in the future, you should totally follow me. Wink, wink. If you're not... you don't have to, though, so, yeah, okay. Yay! Don't ever download TikTok. Speaking of TikTok, my Oshi responded to me, and I was, like, squealing for a good, like, 30 minutes. Like, even when I open it again, even when I open the app again, and I see, Aru Komori, reply to you, I'm like, ah, Aru Komori, my fave, my Oshi, the idol ever, oh my god. I'm so normal about her. I'm so normal about Komori Aru from Gaga Piero. Oh my god. Not to plug my Oshi or anything. But, yeah. That's it. Yep. Follow. That's really it. That's it enough.